We're taking our time. How you doing, Gary?
I'm doing good.
Y'all wanted a loud microphone. You got your wish.
I got it.
Down in Jamaica, they got lots of pretty women. Steal your money, then break your heart. Lonesome Sue, she's in love with old Sam. Takes it from the fire to the frying pan. This is old Jimmy, he's alone in the moon. Keep on. Saw his woman kiss another man. So he takes a ladder, steals the stars from the sky. Puts on Sinatra, starts to cry. On and on, he just keeps on trying. And he smiles when he feels like crying. Zach Brown, eat your heart out. Woman left me for another man. So I know right, I just dream and stay tight. Toss up my heart, see where it lands. On and on, I'll just keep on crying. And I smile when I feel like crying. On and on, on and on, on and on. Trying. And I smile when I feel like crying. On and on, 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 on and on. I'm not doing that high note. Potter, I ain't. Bette Midler, I sure ain't. And Beyonce, forget about it.
Bette Midler.
Sure good to be back in St. Louis Park. This is our favorite gig of the whole summer. Started here many years ago. Jim, would you like to come up and say a word or two on behalf of the Rotary of St. Louis Park? Please welcome the chairman, chief poobah, and grand master of all things important. This is Jim from the Rotary of St. Louis Park. You want to grab that mic right there, Jim? All right. Oh, come on. Give him more than that, y'all. He's on TV. He's in people's living rooms.
Actually, before I talk about Rotary, get right up on it. This place is kind of special for me. I was on the city council when we built Excelsior and Grand, the first mixed-use development in the Twin Cities. This amphitheater was part of that. Jim Rhodes, our state senator, got money out of the legislature to build this amphitheater. It was very controversial. We built those two pavilions back there, equally controversial, but the most controversial was the sculpture you see in the roundabout up here.
Yeah, tell us about it.
It was, we had a contest. We had a committee select four artists. They got it down to four. They brought us in and presented it to us. One of them was the naked lady. The mayor at that time went ballistic. We can't have a naked lady in St. Louis Park. 13-year-old kids will be standing around looking up at it. And I looked at the rest of the council. I said, perfect. That's the one we're doing. And there she is.
Well, he objected because it was probably his wife.
No, it wasn't. Anyway.
That's great. You know, can I jump in with a story in Nashville?
Yeah.
We have a statue like that at the top of Music Row. It's called Musique. Why it's called Musique? It's naked dancers of both sexes, fully exposed, posing, and artistically arrayed in a group. It's like a pile of humans. And somebody wrote a song, and I don't remember the first part of it, but it went around for a little while after it came in, and it said, tourists are, let's see, the men sure look chilly, the women look proud. Something or other, it's drawing a crowd. The tourists are gawking and honking their horns. The mayor done bought us some hillbilly porn.
There you go. Now, what's ironic, about 3 or 4 weeks after that, the mayor took a bunch of school kids to the state capitol. He said, do you know how many naked women there are in the rotunda of the state capitol? It's like 5 or 6.
Really?
Yeah, I didn't know that.
Well, let's organize a field trip.
There you go. Anyway, my name is Jim Brimmeyer. I'm now president of the St. Louis Park Rotary Club. I was president back in 1987 and 88. When I was president then, we had 140 members. Now we got about 24 members. We've been around St. Louis Park since 1947. The sculptures you see at the Nature Center, we're responsible for that. The showmobile that does performances around the city, we're responsible for that. And now they gave me a speech to read. Our Rotary Club sponsors this concert series. We have a winter fun day, sometime in January, as I recall, raise about $1,500, give that to the city that sponsors these concerts.
Wow.
You can check out the city website for other dates of this free series. It's made possible by St. Louis Park Rotary. We have two Rotary clubs. We have one that meets at noon, one that meets on Friday. We've been around since 47. The Sunrise Club, I think we started that in 83 or 84, and we do a lot of things together. Our service, our motto is service above self, and we're always open to anybody in this audience that would like to join us. So check out our website, rotaryslp.org. And I kind of imitate Joe Souchere when I say, make sure you put the dot in there.
Jeez.
So anyway,
Joe, let's talk about Joe.
Check us out on our
have
website.
To bring him up?
Huh?
Never.
Why did we bring him up? Because he and I know him.
Yes.
I'm a fan of his, and he's been on his show. That's how I heard about you in the first place.
Is it really?
Yeah.
That is amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Jim. Right.
Thank you so much.
We were playing the Liney Lodge, you know, I think in 2019 or something like that, right before COVID, and you know they called up and said, hey, we've had, oh, and some of the people couldn't get into from out of the country because of COVID and travel, and so they called us up and said, well, we'd see you're in town, would you come down? And so they asked me, would you go do this thing called Garage Logic? And I didn't know what it was. I thought it was about wrenches and stuff, you know. And I went over to this little house over by Channel 5, yeah, and doggone, if these guys weren't like the fishing, bare-legged knuckleheads of all time, and just so much fun, and Rookie and all those guys, and Joe, and I just love Joe. He's like Uncle Joe to me now. And so last April, I got to be on the show for the whole show, and he said, you don't know how happy we are, relieved that we don't have to talk about all of that other stuff that he says. So I just adore Joe. I've named him one of my favorite knuckleheads. And, you know, guys, thank anybody listening to him, thank you. And it's awesome that we get asked to do stuff like this. So we're happy to be back. Our first time here was back when Kevin Odegaard was doing the music of Bob Dylan here in the park.
I can't remember the year.
I don't remember, but it was the salute. It was the Blood on the Tracks live. And so over here on the bass guitar, I'm going to prevail on him right away and sing a little Bob Dylan. This is a song he doesn't know still.
Very little.
This came out in 74, and he's still learning it.
Too many verses. You must be a genius.
So for all you St. Louis Park people.
Early one morning the sun was shining. I was lying in bed. Wondering if she changed it all, if her hair was still red. She said that our lives together sure was gonna be rough. Never did like mama's homemade dress. Papa's bankroll wasn't big enough. And now I'm standing on the edge of the road. The Dayton is rolling on my knees. Staring off to the East Coast. Lord knows I've paid my dues. Getting through.
Tangled up in blue.
She was married when we first met. Soon to be divorced. Of a jam, I guess, but I use a little too much force. We drove that car as far as I could, abandoned it out west. Lit up on a dock one night, both believing it was best. She turned to me and looked around when I was walking away. I heard her say over my shoulder, we'll meet again someday on the avenue.
Tangled up in blue. Over there.
That wasn't improvised. I don't know what was.
You know what? You had a cue card over here. This guy knows all the words.
Oh, I wish.
I would have just followed him, man. He'd probably lead you the right way. So we're delighted to be here, though, and I don't think that we would be here. I know I wouldn't have the career I've had without running into Glenn Campbell in Phoenix back in 1987. And Tom Benton here on the drums, originally from Phoenix, now in Wisconsin. Let's hear it for Tom. That was warm and big. And Tom and I were playing the Coliseum opening for the Judds in Alabama and Merle Haggard. And Glenn Campbell showed up, asked to meet me. And the very next night, there he was at a private party. And I asked him to sit in because we were old friends by then. And it went great. And he called us 2 days later and he said, boys, I love your band. And Jeff, I'd like to take you guys on the road. And that's how it got started. And so I wouldn't do a show anywhere ever without at least acknowledging old Glenn and thanking him for the gift he gave us. It's knowing that your door is always open and your path is free to walk. That makes me tend to leave my sleeping bag rolled up and stashed behind your couch. And it's knowing I'm not shackled by forgotten words and bonds and the ink stains that it dried upon some line that keeps you on the back roads by the rivers of my memory, keeps you ever gentle on my mind. And it's not clinging to the rocks and ivy planted on their columns now than by me. Or something that somebody said, cause they thought we fit together walking. It's just knowing that this world will not be cursing or forgiving when I walk along some railroad track and find that you're waving on backwards by the rivers of my memory, and for hours to just tingle on my mind. Let me see if I can get lucky, guys. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. We, after the Bob Dylan things got going, we really, it kind of evolved into the music of Bob Dylan. Salute to the music of Bob Dylan. Instead of Blood on the Tracks.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the original show was built around the guys from Minnesota who actually played on Blood on the Tracks on that album. And I'm sure most of you know the story, just like you know about the purple guy that was here, Prince. I should tell you, Gary's got a good story about this.
St. Louis Park?
Well, anywhere. I mean, Los Angeles, they'd eat this stuff up. Back in 1976, Gary and I were playing with Kevin Odegaard, who was the guy who played on Blood on the Tracks, and it was his acoustic guitar that opened Tangle Up in Blue. He walked into the studio to drop off a borrowed guitar, and they said, oh, your chair is over there.
Yeah.
And he was like, what? Well, he didn't say anything, but he sat down and said, I'll gladly play on the record. And he parlayed that into a whole thing. In 76, we had the KO band. He had just recorded an album. And our drummer was a young kid from here named Bobby Rifkin. And his older brother David was our engineer, producer. And in 76, we were the house band at a little place in South Minneapolis, 28th and DuPont, called Moon Sound. And there was a kid that would come in there and hang out with us and play guitar and do all these parts. He played the drums, the piano, he sang the vocals, and he wrote the songs. And I had this old Gibson SG that he borrowed, and it was really cool that we got to see this kid doing this. Well, after the band broke up and we went our separate ways, and Bobby said, what do you got, Jeff? And I said, well, I found a gig over on the St. Croix River at the Bungalow, and I'm going to be joining a band over there 5 nights a week doing country. And I said, what about you, Bobby? He said, well, you know that Prince kid that borrows your guitar? I've been jamming with him, and I like what he's doing. And Owen, our manager was Owen Husney, from right here in the park, and Owen got him signed to Warner Brothers, and David was his producer. You know the story. So we were there at the beginning, but even before my little piece of connection with Prince, Gary has a story.
Well, I was in a band also managed by Owen Husney, and
you Dave, guys were going to be the next America. That was sort of the deal.
Three-piece harmony band, yeah. And David was learning how to engineer and produce. And Bobby was also playing drums, just started. And Owen had an ad company, so he's doing jingles. And he throws me and Bobby in the studio to do a jingle. And Prince is on the piano, but I'm 22. He's like 16. This is 74 or something like that. And he really and truly makes the whole session work, because sometimes trying to make sense of these commercials, you know. Anyways.
It wasn't going well.
Wasn't going well until he just started doing stuff. And when it was all done, I swear to God, I said this. I said, God, you're good. You just got to keep playing. I actually said that.
You gave him the push he needed. Yeah.
And I bet he's looking around going, I can outplay every one of you guys in this studio, and you're telling me to...
There's a lot of talent there. Gary Lopak from Lakeland, Minnesota right now.
16.
Yeah. You grew up in Robbinsdale, right? Or Crystal? Robbinsdale.
Went to school in Robbinsdale and moved, ended up graduating from Cooper.
Oh, wow. Remember the old days, you guys? Yep.
When people graduated? Well, I don't know what you're...
That's a good one. Actually, that's painfully true these days. My son Brenner was a senior at York High School in Elmhurst, Illinois, and when COVID hit at the March of 2020, he was a senior. He wasn't doing particularly well. In fact, he was in danger of going back to eighth grade, I think. He was just
they don't do that anymore.
But what happened was, because they shut down the schools and stuff, when they got to about May, the governor of the state said, well, y'all graduate. Bye. No walking, no diplomas, no prom, no none of that. So he got his degree, or his diploma, on a year when graduating was not, he probably wouldn't have. I don't know. Man, I'll tell you what, though, I love being a dad, and I have five kids, Noah, Carrie, Brenner, Kenna, and Kessler. And Kenna is 20, and she has a new baby, and I'm a grandpa. Yeah. I'm G-Pop for a seven-week-old grandson. And anyway, let's go ahead and do a little fishing music. You guys been fishing?
I have.
Have you?
Yes.
What are you going for?
I usually go for bluegill or crappie. I like the panfish.
That's like bait fish.
Not when you eat them.
Tom and I were touring with Glenn Campbell, one time they brought this big spread of like vegetables and salads, and he says, that's not food, that's what food eats. Yeah. So let's do a little fishing. I like to say, give a man a fish, he'll eat for a day. Teach a man to fish, and I'll say he'd go for walleye all summer long. You got a line, and I got a pole. You and me, baby, let's take a stroll. Wander on down to the water side. Put a little bait and see what bites. Cause I love fishing with you, baby. I love your little catch reeler. I love the way you tease me. One little wiggle and I'm on the hook. So cute in your summertime hat, makes my little heart go pitter-pat. You're so fine, sitting in a boat, knock me in the water, Lord, I hope I float. Cause I love fishing with you, baby. I love your little catch me look. I love the way you tease me. One little wiggle and I'm on the hook. Track, betting on a pony named Surefire Jack. Jack was a winner, I was too, so I bought a big boat and an ebon roo. Slice of bologna, slice of cheese, chips and a pickle and a sweet iced tea. Nothing in the bucket, nothing on the line, but one of your kisses, baby, I'm just fine. Cause I love fishing with you, baby. Your little catch me look. I love the way you tease me. One little wiggle and I'm on the hook. One little wiggle and I'm on the hook. One little wiggle and I'm on the hook. Woo-hoo. Yeah, fishing with it, baby.
get the grills going. The coals are going. Let's find something else to cook up. I want to hear some funky Dixieland. Pretty mama, come and take me by the hand. By the hand. Take me by the hand. Pretty mama, dance with the baby all night long. Want to hear some funky Dixieland. Pretty mama, come and take me by the hand. By the hand. Take me by the hand. Hand be doing that. All right. You know, we got here and it was raining. It was spitting at 4 o'clock. It's spitting a little more at 4:15. Spitting even more and thunder and stuff at 4:30. And I told Katie over here, we're courageous or crazy, but we're setting up. And we're going to wait it out. And you look at you guys. We love you. You're courageous and crazy. Brave. And so for you, I'm looking at, there's some squinting going on here because there's this bright yellow object in the sky. Where did, it's eyes can't see.
It wasn't there
too bright,
a minute ago.
Too bright. So come on, hippies, you can help us on this one too. Thank you, guys. Tom Benton on the drums back there. Give it up for Tom.
Hello. Hello. I'm up there. I just wasn't close. I'm close. Hey.
Tom and I started out together in about 85, I think.
84, actually.
Wow.
84. Goes,
yeah, right after Mickey McGee mutinied.
You know, I took a tally the other day on how many years we've actually worked together, actually on a stage. 18 years.
Wow.
9 at first and 9 now.
Love it. Aren't you guys impressed? This guy is one of the best drummers I've ever worked with. Tom Benton, come on.
Thank you.
All right. And he's playing his butt off tonight. Pardon, I just said that on TV.
He doesn't you have can much
bleep,
left.
You can bleep that, yeah. That's right, that's why it's hardly there. Here's one for the sunshine tonight. It's just so great to see. How are you doing, man? You got a smile as big as the sunshine already. All right, and you brought your sunshine partner. I like those colors. Vikings purple. Love it, love it. I live in Nashville, Tennessee. Been there 23 years. And for 21 years before that, I lived in Arizona, in the Phoenix area. Fountain Hills was my first home down there. And for the first 25 years of my life, born and raised right here in Minnesota, Long Lake, Minnesota, y'all. So, hey, good to be home. And I'm a Vikings fan. I'm watching the Twins on MLB channel on YouTube, and I get 8-minute highlights without a spoiler. So I get to see the Twins like when they beat them. Oh, they can't say that, can they? Like when Buxton hit two dingers, finally broke the streak, 0-26, and the first homer he hit, I thought it was a kid at Christmas, man. It's like, yes! And then he hit another one. He was like, okay! I love that about the Twins, and I've been a Twins fan since 61 when they got here, and my grandmother, Erna Conroy. You remember George Conroy's restaurant in St. Paul? Anybody? Is this our friend Dr. Blackburn? I'm so glad to see you, sir. All we've done is talk on the internet. This is Dr. Henry Blackburn, pioneer of Dixieland music in Minnesota. He said that my grandmother gave him his first gig in music at her restaurant in St. Paul. That's amazing. And then I know that you had another piece of history. In fact, when she gave him the gig, he said, I don't know what to do. She said, fine, you're hired. But what's the story about the Preservation Hall Jazz Band? Tell us. I know you don't have a microphone, but you were the one that brought them here to Minnesota, weren't you? All of Minnesota's connection with Preservation Hall is thanks to Dr. Henry Blackburn right here. Many, many years of wonderful music. And... That was a long time ago.
70s, I went and saw them.
Well, it's just amazing. And wonderful clarinetist, and just a wonderful musician, but a super kind guy. And if my grandmother Erna liked him, he had to be good. So this is how long I've been here. Erna had season tickets to the Twins in 61. Box seats were $6 a game. And that she bought that little box, you know, that little card. It was like a hard paper box with two slots in it for each of the tall, skinny. Remember the tall, skinny tickets? Yeah, and all the tickets for the whole season were in there. And in 1965, when I was 12 years old, the Twins were hosting the All-Star Game. I got to be there and see that, and I have the program. And that year later on, they played the Dodgers in the World Series, and I got two nights of watching the Dodgers and the Twins in the World Series, have those programs too. So I've been a Twins fan forever. And when I was that age, I knew all the players and their numbers, had them memorized. You know, Harmon and Allison and Lenny Green, number 7, Earl Batty. I mean, I was just such a huge fan. And then they hired that kid, Zoilo Versalles, at shortstop. You know what his signing bonus was? $1,500. I think there'd be a stink. That's more than the postage they work on players.
He was rookie of the year, wasn't he?
Zoilo?
Maybe.
I don't remember. I think in 65, though, Rich Rollins was rookie of the year. 30 homers and 30 stolen bases at third base. You guys remember Rich Rollins?
Yeah.
Am I just talking to myself?
Nope.
Okay, all right. So here in honor of our sunshine right now, I do talk a lot. One lady last night chewed me out for talking. She said, talk on YouTube. Just sing. She was the only one that said that, though. Some There's a place that I've heard of once in a lullaby. Skies are blue like the ones over St. Louis Park right now. And the dreams that you dare to dream really can come true. Ooh, someday I wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. Yeah. Thank you for the help. Thank you so much. Key is C sharp, boys. That's D flat for the horn players, which they like that. I never forget. I was playing at a place down in Chanhassen long gone. It was called School of the Wise. And a guy named Jeff Carver was playing trumpet in the other end. And he was in the wine room, and I was out in the dinner room. And I went back there and said, "Man, you sound great. Bring that flugelhorn and come sit in with me." I said, he came over after he was done, and I said, "Why don't we do," he goes, "What do you want to do?" I said, "How about we do Route 66 in B flat?" And he went, "You'd do that for me?" You bet I would. So this one's in C sharp, written with a whole bunch of fifth graders. I think we're out in Minnewashta Elementary in Minnetonka. There's a wonderful program that I do out there called Making Music Nashville Style. And the Lois was the one who came up with it, Lois Sorted All, and she's right back there. We're going to embarrass her later when she has to sing with us. She dressed to sing.
And we team up the kids in bands. We call them bands, they're small groups. And they write songs according to what they want to write. They'll come up with the title, and they'll come up with the ingredients, and then I just help them, you know. I say, go get me Legos, and I'll help you build a cool fort. So they brought me this. They heard me say the word chillo. And they said, can we write that? I said, sure, it's fair game. I said it. So we wrote that, and it came in about, I don't know, a day and a half. And we just, man, and I said, here's the cool thing about it. Most of those kids were special needs kids. Don't ever underestimate a kid based on some label that they stick on them. These kids were brilliant and amazing. And this song was so good, in my opinion, that I put it on my latest record. So I hope you guys like this. It's going out to all the fans of Songwriters Island. Hello, Sam, wherever you are. Look at me, just relaxing on a beach. There's nothing on my mind at all. Watching the sand crabs crawl. Lemonade, big umbrella in the shade. Grooving to a potion's tune. Drifting through the islands. Yeah, I'm chilling. Let's hear it for the fifth graders. Yeah. That's really cool. I love it. All right, we're going to go, let's see, what are we going to do? I wanted to do something y'all know and not just hit you with my stuff. This is one that I grew up with in high school. You probably did too. Let's see if we can do this one, all right? You can help me out.
If I ever lose my legs, oh, will
just if I ever lose my eyes away, I won't have to cry no more, as I'm being followed by a moon shadow. Okay, Dr. Blackburn, this is for you and all the jazzers. In B flat, this is my new favorite. Is that right? For all the Sinatra fans, you guys ready for this?
Oh, great.
Two of you are good. Catch up. Well, grab your coat and snatch your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Just erect your feet on the sunny side of the street. When you hear that pitter-pat and that happy tune is yours to. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with the blues on parade. No longer afraid, all the rover crossed over. If I didn't have a cent, I'd be rich as Rockefeller. Gold dust at my feet on the sunny side of the street. Get sunny there. A gentleman here said he used to have one of these, a black Les Paul from the 50s, and he sold it for $10.
There's a guy that just showed up who's got the real thing.
There is?
He's right there.
And he's got a real one?
What year, 68?
You got a 68 Black Beauty?
With three pickups?
Two. Ooh. Two gold ones? Three. Gold or silver? Really?
Yeah, it's
beautiful. I'm intimidated. This is only an Epiphone. Man, that's cool. That is really cool. I'd sold one. I've traded I took out a loan for $300 from Western State Bank in Marshall, and I bought a Les Paul Black Beauty, Fretless Wonder. And I didn't think much of the guitar. It was all beat up. But I had at the time, I had a 410 57 Tweed Bassman. And we were playing in the cafeteria doing a talent show in college. And I kept getting louder like the bands always do. And I turned around, I turned it up. And finally, I went. And I was like, whoa, what's that? I love that. And I, of course, then, like an idiot, I traded it straight across for a burned out old Leslie speaker that only had one speed.
Beautiful idea.
It was worth about $20. But that's the lessons we learn, anyhow. We'll do a little something featuring Gary's harmony, and we're going to... A little bit of JJ. Well, they call me the breeze. I keep blowing down the road. Yeah, they... Electric Stratocaster, Mr. Mark Bendixson.
I got that green light, baby. I got to keep moving on.
California, maybe Minnesota, I don't know.
Y'all help us now. Let's play some country. Let's play some country.
Yeah!
Come on, somebody help me out. Merle Haggard style. Well, it's a hard job just getting by, 9 kids and a wife. I've been a working man dang near all my life, but I'll be working long as these two hands are fit to use. Drink my beer in the evening, sing a little bit of these working man blues. Yeah, I keep my nose to the grindstone, work hard every day, get a little time on the weekend after I drop my pay, but I'll keep working. Gotta buy these kids a brand new pair of shoes. 5 kids, that's a lot of shoes. Keep my nose to the grindstone, sing a little bit of these working man blues. Be working long as these two hands are fit to use. Yeah, I've been a little time on the weekend, sing a little bit of these working man blues. Down low for Gary. Thank you. working man like me. Never been on welfare, that's one place I won't be. Cause I'll be working long as these two hands are fit to use. Yeah, I get a little tired on the weekend, sing a little bit of these working man blues. Yeah, I love to come home to Minnesota, sing a little bit of these working man blues. One for the working man. Tom Benton on the drums, everybody. Gary Lopak on the bass. Mark Bendixson on guitar, all the way from Independence, Minnesota. Katie, did you have an announcement about your goodies and stuff over here? Come on. We chide everybody into getting on the microphone. So, Katie, don't even try to do it from there. You get up
what
here.
What she's got?
She's got some. Don't try from there. You have to get up here. I love to do that to people. Don't you hate me now?
But I'm here representing the city of St. Louis Park, and I have some brochures over here if you wanted to pick any up. It looks like there is an upcoming, maybe new event, and so I have a brochure. Stop by the table. But thanks for being here.
You got off easy. I'm going to let the boys take a break here. I'm going to play a little something. And as Glenn Campbell used to say, I'm going to stand here and pick, and you guys stand there and marvel. I love getting to do this. This, you know, I saw Jackson Browne on the Running on Empty tour. I saw Crosby, Stills, and French Fries. You know, all the songs, all the shows where the songwriter came out. And I think I'm going to try one. In fact, I'm going to dedicate this to David Lindley, Jackson's lap steel player. We lost him this year. But that moment where they would have, like, the Oriental rugs out in the middle, and he would sit down at a chair. I got to tell you about my chair. Like this, it's real leather, I think, or pleather. It's sturdy as heck. It's got these nice brass fittings, and I picked this up at Goodwill on Thursday for $19.99. There's the Scottish in me, man. And this cabinet here with this holding my mixer and my tray of goodies underneath it, that was a roadside find today out in Orono. I hit the brakes, did a U-turn, put on my flashers, and I grabbed that before the security cameras were triggered. Yeah. I'm a dad, as I mentioned, I'm a dad of five kids, three grandkids. Nothing else in the forecast right now. Speaking of forecast, ha, ha, ha. How about it? You guys turned up and you scared all the raindrops away. And, you know, I've got a wonderful bunch of kids. And I got the coolest Father's Day card from my son, Kessler. He said, Dad, thank you so much for being back in my life again. You know, there was a time when the kids were just basically like middle finger, we don't need you, Dad, you know. And then this year in May, he called up and he said, Dad, can I come live with you? I just can't take Mom anymore. I was like, come on, buddy, welcome home. I've been keeping that room for you all this time. Let's see if I can do this without losing my tear ducts. I'm an everyday dad with a bunch of kids. Raising them right is a real kick. It's an old days off kind of double shift. Just about to wear me out. Well, then one of them angels will hug my neck. Kiss my cheek with those little lips and skip the dishes, forget the mess. This is what it's all about. And I tell them at night when I tuck them in how much daddy loves each of them. Tell them in the morning when they wake me up, hope my heart will be big enough. I told you last night I couldn't love you more, but that's not true. Cause today I do. I got wacky pack tour spilling out of my car. Kitchen's all covered in crayon art. Taped to the fridge, there's what a caller heart says. Daddy, I love you.
Yeah, one's got a fever and a runny nose. One's learned to take off all his clothes. And one won't listen when you tell her no. And all I can really do is tell him at night when I tuck him in how much daddy loves each of them. Tell him in the morning when they wake me up, hope my heart will be big enough. Told you last night I couldn't love you more, but that's not true, 'cause today I do. Yeah, moms and dads all know it's a lot to go through, but the good news is we get to. Tell them at nine when we tuck them in how much we love each of them. Tell them in the morning when they wake us up, hope our hearts will be big enough. Told you last night I couldn't love you more, but that's not true, 'cause today I do. No, that's not true, 'cause today I do. Today I do, yeah.
Hey. Thank you, guys. Thanks for the privilege of playing my songs here. Songs are like our kids, you know. Songwriters, we write song after song after song, and in Nashville especially, it's a town of nope, 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 nope. We eat no for lunch in Nashville. We get it all the time. Oh, good. My ride's here. And you have to develop just that kind of duck's back, you know, where the water runs off your back. You have to accept rejection and move on. And when you guys are out there and I'm playing songs that I've written and you guys clap, that is the highest compliment you can pay a writer, is when you listen and when you applaud. So thank you guys so much. I really appreciate that. John, you might know this song. This is from the Calypso Poet album. I did an album during COVID. I have 16 albums out, but as Vince Gill said, I can't prove it because ain't nobody got none of them. You can find them online, though. I'm sold out of everything except for the old Glen Campbell record that I did called The Glen Connection, but it's on Spotify and Amazon Digital and iTunes, whatever that is now, Apple Music. And I tell you, it really is starting to help. So if you guys would check it out online and do that. This song is really personal to me, and I don't usually play it. But since I was on the topic of kids, and, you know, we were all kids once, so. Someday they'll open a page and find the heart
of an old gray ghost. Fight through a little of that. All right. Check this out. Everybody feeling good? Aren't you glad you came tonight? I'm glad you came tonight. And City St. Louis Park, thank you. And Park Rotary, thank you. And citizens of our planet, thank you. You know? We have a gift here. We have this planet, this amazing, beautiful, just creation of a place to live. And it's up to us how that goes. And I hope that you guys will find it in your hearts to put some of that aloha that you feel, you know, some of the mana of spirit, as they say in Hawaii, and go share that with somebody today. You know, let somebody in traffic and just say, this is from me to you. Don't worry about it. You win. You're first. Go for it. Checkered flag, you know. And ask somebody about their life. You know, when I talk to people, I've learned over the years not to just do the talking, but to start doing the listening. And I think it was Paul Harvey that said, I never learned anything by talking. Or maybe it was Larry King. You know? And the other one was, nobody erected, I think it was Larry King that said, no one ever erected a statue to a pessimist. This is an old one. You guys help me out if you want to. It's a good song from the South. Midway Stadium in 1971. I was there in bell-bottom jeans watching Poco, and It's a Beautiful Day, and the Allman Brothers with Duane. Mark, you want to help out on this one? Just you and me. Best I can, and when it's time for leaving, I hope you'll understand that I was born a rambling man. My father was a gambler down in Georgia, wound up on the wrong end of a gun, and I was born sing if you want to. Lord, I was born a rambling man, trying to make a living, doing the best I can. And when it's time for leaving, I hope you'll understand that I was born a rambling man. Thank the world.
world of me. Lord, I was born a rambling man, trying to make a living and doing the best I can. Well, when it's time for leaving, I hope you'll understand that I was born.
Good night, Dr. Blackburn. So good to see you, sir. Oh, you just moving? Okay. Yeah, you can watch my amazing fingers from over there.
Mark Bendixson on guitar.
We keep losing the great ones, don't we? This is an F sharp if you want to swing it. You want to swing it at an outside pitch? We played Bayfield, Wisconsin at Big Top Chautauqua back in June. Cool venue, man. What? You never would have thought so. All they had out there were mosquitoes and trees. Yeah. But we got to go up there and on the south side of the south shore of Lake Superior, I was channeling me some Gordon Lightfoot.
She's been looking like a queen in a sailor's dream, and she don't always say what she really means. Sundown, you better take care.
Hey, Tom, sing a harmony.
Sundown, you better take care. If I find you be creeping around my back stairs. I can see you laying back in a faded dress, in a room where you do what you don't confess. Sometimes I think it's a sin when I get better when I'm losing again. Sundown, you better take care. If I find you've been creeping round my back stairs.
Yeah. I think Harry's getting ready here.
Looking like a queen in a sailor's dream. She's a hard-loving woman. If I find you've been creeping round my back stairs.
It's an arrangement. Paul Peel's Pocket Arranger. Ignore the hand. All right. You guys having fun? We are. You know what I got to say? I'm not the oldest guy here, finally.
I am.
But I like sitting down. I do. This is a comfy chair. $19.95 worth of pump comfy. If it was $19.99, I probably would have not taken it.
I hear it's real leather.
Or
Cordova. Or
yeah. Have you seen my new Cordova? Rich Corinthian leather. Any furniture toolers here? Any furniture makers?
Besides me?
Well, Tom, you used to build cabinets and stuff.
I had my own cabinet shop for a long time.
Yeah, I'm going to take this to some place that has that double-stitch, gokey leather kind of place, you know, and get them to recover this thing, because I do think that this might be, well, it might have been the unfortunate end for a bunch of Nagas. You know how many Nagas had to give their life for this chair? Which is a sad story. It's adopt a Naga today. They're everywhere.
Adopt a Naga. Adopt a Naga.
Well, let's see here. Let's do some fun. We don't know any fun ones. Here's a song of mine from a long time ago. This written for my 22-year-old son, who's at the time was 16. Well, you ain't gonna lay around all summer long to get a job. Sleeping like an old hound dog, get a job. Yeah, get your laundry off the floor, 'cause mama ain't your maid no more. And get your lazy butt out the door and get a job. No, you ain't gonna eat us out of house and home, get a job. It's about dang time you brought some bacon home, get a job. Oh, you ain't gonna drive my truck, and I ain't giving you a buck. So get your motivator unstuck and get a job. Oh, get one more, kid. On guitar, Gary Lopak on the bass, Tom Benton on the drums, and Gary, would you do one for us?
Yeah, which one?
I don't. What was that one that we didn't know, but we did it anyway? It was like that. It was that old R&B thing? Remember? Yeah, wait, that wasn't the one though. You mean the Ringo song? Yeah. What?
No, it was like I'm blanking out.
Me too.
Do you guys remember what it was? Well, we got a special guest here today. She's a record background singer from Nashville, and we're delighted to have her here. She came in just for this and her one song cameo from the album Calypso Poet, from the song Bye Bye Boogie. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Lois Sort It All. They're all going, what the heck?
Recorded in Jeff Dayton's studio.
During COVID, we were all appropriately spaced. No one else could. No, and nobody,
yeah,
there was.
Right. That's it.
Well, nobody else would come to town.
That's a very good point. She said no one else was there to do it.
Yeah.
So okay. Let's get going.
Tried to get the mailman to do it.
No. Dog walker. All right, here we go. Let's see if I can do this right. Minnesota loves its boogie blues. There's a little gal used to be mine. We were always having us a real good time. Just when I thought we were doing all right, she up and left in the middle of the night. She did the boogie.
Did the boogie.
She did the bye-bye boogie. She did the skip town, see you around the ice cold, don't you know? Wham, bam, alabam. Bye, bye, boogie. Well, I gave that woman everything I got. All she ever gave me was a real cold shot. She left my heart all bruised and broke. Didn't even bother with a goodbye note. That's the boogie.
That's the boogie.
That's the bye-bye boogie.
That's the bye-bye boogie.
That's the skip town, see you around. Ice cold, don't you know? Wham, bam, alabam.
Bye-bye
sing. He'll probably wind up all by himself, cause her ice cold heart ain't never gonna melt. That's the boogie.
That's the boogie.
That's the bye bye boogie.
That's the bye bye boogie.
That's the skip town, see you around. Ice cold, don't you know? Wham bam, alabam.
Bye bye boogie.
Yeah, that's the boogie.
That's the boogie.
That's the bye.
a big old ring. But he can't jam, not like that man can. Shook proud and wound up all by himself, cause your ass caught hard ain't never gonna melt. That's the boogie.
That's the boogie.
That's the bye-bye boogie.
That's the bye-bye boogie.
That's the skip town, see you around. Ice cold, don't you know? Wham, bam, alabam. Bye-bye boogie. They got a lot of nice girls.
Well, we have chewed up a lot of time, and we haven't even talked to y'all for a minute. How are you doing? Everybody doing okay? Anybody need anything from the gift shop? No? Okay. Anybody need a bottle of water? Yes? I have a couple right here, and only had a little out of each one. Oh, God. I'm always in a goofy mood when I'm here. But, Gary, isn't this one of the coolest gigs of the year, always?
Yeah, this is a great place. Yeah,
and I love watching. Are those gladiolas?
No, those are hydrangeas.
Hydrangeas.
Something said, like that. I don't know.
Hypothermias.
Hydroxias.
Let's see here. Let's do. This is a cool one. My house growing up, my mom was so hip, she bought the first Beatles record, I Want to Hold Your Hand. Of course, I lost my mind. Mom, I love you. She goes, I know you already said that. And there was a super group that came together right after Cream with Rick Gretsch and Eric Clapton from Cream. Ginger Baker and Eric Clapton from Cream. We got a white dog, and my mom named it Vanilla Cream because our first two favorite albums in the house were Vanilla Fudge and Cream. And then that group split up, and Clapton and Ginger Baker went with Rick Gretsch, and this amazing guy on the keyboards and guitars could sing his you-know-what off. Stevie Winwood. Come down off your throne, leave your body alone. Somebody must change. You are the reason I've been waiting so long. Somebody holds the key. Well, I'm near the end, and I just ain't got the time. I know, and I'm wasted, and I can't find my way home.
Thank you.
and I can't find nothing wrong. No, I can't find my way home. No, no, I can't find my way home. And I can't find nothing wrong. No, but I can't find my way home.
That's a fun song.
I never met a girl anywhere didn't think this song was all for her.
Ships a day, lonely sailors pass the time away, talking about their homes. And there's a girl in this harbor town, and she works wearing whiskey down. They say, "Brandy, fetch another round." She serves them whiskey and wine. The sailors say, "Brandy, you're a fine girl. A braided chain made of finest silver in north of Spain, and a locket that bears the name of the man that Brandy loves.
You got it?
Yeah, he came on a summer's day bearing gifts from far away, but he made it clear he could not stay. No harbor was his own. You'd hear him say, "Brandy, yes, she loved to hear him tell his tale. He told his sailor story. She could feel the ocean rise and fall. She could feel its rage and glory. But he always told the truth. Lord, he was an honest man. And Brandy does her best. The bars closed down. Brandy walks through a silent town. Loves a man he's not around. She still can hear him say. She hears him say, "Brandy, you're a fine girl.
You're a fine
what a good wife you would be.
Such a fine girl.
Oh, my life, my love and my lady is a seed."
That's so much fun to play. I believe, in my short-sighted, humble opinion, that that's the only song in the world with that chord progression. If you can name it, can you name another song with that chord progression? I can't either. It's 1, 3 minor, 2 minor, 6, 2 minor, 4, flat 7, 4.
Yeah.
1,
I don't
3 know. Minor, 2 minor, 6, 4, 4, 1. In Nashville, the number system helps you a lot. I had the advantage of studying at the University of Minnesota when I was in the jazz ensemble underneath Dr. Frank Ben Cresciuto, and got to play guitar in that number one band, Scotty Sansby, Peter Murray, Steve, Dan Cleary, Dave Hagedorn. I mean, a wonderful bunch of musicians. We worked with Dizzy Gillespie and Thad Jones and Phil Woods, and we went to Mexico City and did a tour down there, and I learned how to ask for water with gas and ice, because you didn't supposed to drink out of the tap water. And Dr. Ben was so freaked out that some of these blue-eyed, blonde-haired kids were going to get stolen and sold to South America that he was the nervous mother hen of the bunch. But I was studying with a guy named Lee Humphreys, and he wrote the textbook on sight singing and ear training. It was Whitlitch and Humphreys, and that guy taught us to sight read clarinet music using numbers. So in whatever key it was, if it was in E flat, we would sing 1 flat 3 2 4 1 flat 3 7 5 4 sharp 4 5 5 7 1 flat 3 2 4 flat 3 5 flat 6 4 5 flat 3 2 7 1. If you can do that, then you can play guitar in Nashville. It's so great to be a Nashville guitar player, and I hope you guys will come visit someday. I don't play down there a whole lot because the place is crowded with tourists, bachelorette parties, girls' getaway weekends, and people riding tractors go, "I'm so drunk." That's what they call the mating call of the Southern Belle, you know. And but we'll hope you guys will come to town and see the history we've got there. Best guitar players in the world, they shred our best days 5 at a time. And I've gotten to record with most of my idols, and it's just amazing. If you want to hear the music again, it's online on Spotify. If you would click subscribe there, or if you go to YouTube and see my videos about salads and campfires and sunsets and things like that, soup that I make, you know, it's all fun. And we're going to do this little thing here to remember our late buddies that we used to play this stage with, the great Peter Ostrushko. You can help us out. The late, great Billy Hallquist. We sure miss Billy. The late, great Lonnie Knight. Standing right here next to the tallest guy I've ever played guitar with. And he was a fearsome guy. A long time ago, one of our friends said, "You guys should start a band called Knight and Dayton."
Yeah.
Gary, who else am I missing? Who else have we lost? Too many. Way too many. Of course, we have to say, back to the roots of our days here in town, and all the musicians loved Jeff Hill and Newt Coupe music.
Well,
we didn't forget him. We just were talking about people that played here. Jeff,
yeah.
I don't think Jeff did. But thank you guys for being part of this music tonight. And let's see here. I'm going to do this one for, let's see. This is for Lonnie, okay? And for Billy. And for all of us. And we're going to we'll turn it up a little bit, all right? Oh, I don't see no eyes. Is that it? No? Yeah. Crossroads.
Wonder Peggy ride. Nobody recognized me, they only passed me by. Friend Willie Brown, go down to the crossroads, tell my good friend Willie Brown, going down to the crossroads, believe I'm sinking down. Everybody, thank you so much. Not leaving, I noticed. Thank you guys. As Glenn used to say, I was all the way out in my limousine and I heard your applause, I came running back. This is a little thing for all of you. I wrote the song on a dare. I was writing for a publishing company called Blackwater, or Bandwagon Red. They said, we need a song, we're going to go pitch a song in 15 minutes. And I said, okay, I'll write one. They said, no, you don't understand. We're going to pitch the song in 15 minutes, and you don't even have it written. I said, I'll write it in 15 minutes. They said, well, you don't even have a demo. I said, I don't care. And they said, well, we're leaving, forget you. And they went off without me. And I said, well, heck with you. I'm going to go in the kitchen and write this song. And it took about 20 minutes. And I hope you guys enjoy this from us to you. I don't walk a straight and narrow. I don't care if people stare on it. I don't need no criticizing. People try to change my mind. So what? I can't wear somebody else's shoes. I can only be me, win or lose. So walk with me, stand by me, and live like we like and we love. We'll ride the tide with sails on high, fearless and reckless and tough. Some will love you, some won't give a rip. No rhymes with a rip. No, I'm not yellow, blue, or green. There's a color in between, and I'm it. Yes, I am. 'Cause when you're painted by the master's hand, there's no way to be a different man or woman. So walk with me, stand by me. We like and we love. We'll ride the tide with sails on high, fearless and reckless and tough. I dance like I feel it. I call it like I see it. I sing like I was born in you. Don't take me for granted. I stand where I'm planted, and most of all, I stand for. Like I feel it, I call it like I see it, I sing like I was born to do. Don't take me for granted, I stand where I'm planted, and most of all, I stand for all of y'all. 'Cause God bless you all. God bless America. Be kind to each other. Mahalo, kea kua. All right.